You have got to be kidding.
You know, I really, really tried to be optimistic. I mean, really tried. In fact, if you guys remember my last episode and where I spoke about He-Man, I said I would not talk about He-Man up until the part 2 comes out, because I was hoping, like he said, maybe in episode 7 there'd be an epic clash between He-Man and Skeletor. Well, apparently, he might have lied to us again, and now I have to do an update before the second part of season 1 comes out. So here we are, guys. Here we are. Thanks for tuning into the Voice of Reason podcast. I am your host, Dante. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Drop a comment in the comment section so we can discuss this again, because for those of you guys who are following me, we're discussing this already. So let's just continue the discussion. And don't forget, like I always say, giveaways are still on the table for Halo Infinite and God of War Ragnarok. So let's get right into it. So here I was, just minding my business, just going through my phone like everybody else does, until I was going through Google, and the first thing I saw was, of course, He-Man, because that's a popular discussion. And then it said, topic, Masters of the Universe is about to become the ultimate evil Lin story, Kevin Smith says, and I almost lost it. Now, to be fair, it doesn't say it's going to only be about Evil Lin, but according to the title, because a lot of these titles are clickbait, it says it's going to be the ultimate Evil Lin story, which means it's going to possibly be primarily focused on Evil Lin. Where is He-Man? Now, like I said in the beginning of the episode, Kevin Smith said in episode 7, there's going to be an epic battle between He-Man and Skeletor. Well, if there's going to be an ultimate Evil Lin story, right? You guys saw the article, right? You guys seeing it right now? How is it going to be about He-Man if it's an ultimate Evil Lin story? Now, here I am trying to be optimistic. That way, you know, it's like, you know what? Maybe it's not over, right? Granted, the first part of the show was pretty crappy. I know the show is not technically called He-Man and the Masters of the Universe. It's just called Masters of the Universe. But when you watch a show like this, you expect to see more He-Man and less of other characters. And now I'm just baffled as to, was this ever about He-Man? Did he make this show just to focus on other characters, if you know what I mean? And I'm just like, listen, bro. I'm trying to be optimistic. I'm really trying. But you're killing me here, Smalls. You're killing me. And we need more He-Man. We need a He-Man show for this. If this is just a show about the other minions, right? That's fine. But I'm going to need you to create another show for He-Man where he's not killed every other episode. I mean, oh, God. Come on, Kevin. Come on. So, yeah. So, apparently part 2 might possibly be mostly about Evil Lin. So, I'm hoping you guys are checking out this episode. That way, when the part 2 comes out, you wouldn't be as surprised as you would be if you had no idea. You know what? You know what's fine. I continue reading the article. I'm like, you know what? If I continue reading, there might be some positive news, right? And you know what? It just continuously gets worse. Because you know what Kevin says in the article? It's on the screen, obviously, but I'm going to read it to you because I can. He says, you're talking about two women who have been in the shadows of very powerful male characters since the inception of the franchise. Why is it about gender? And Teela, you know, fought side by side with He-Man, definitely like more of his equal. And after that, I dropped my phone because he is called. Okay. Teela is strong. I'm not going to take that away from her. She's trained. She's been in a lot of battles. I'm not even knocking it. She's strong. But to compare Teela to He-Man with cosmic powers, how can you even compare the two characters? Jeez. Oh, God. This is giving me a headache. Okay. So this is what we're looking forward to, guys. Part 2 of Season 1. Like, however they freaking break it up, because now they're doing weird crap on Netflix, okay? But you know what I mean. Don't expect much from the next part. Go in with your expectations supremely low. I'm pretty sure it is already. But if you add any glimmer of hope that the second part would be any better, I'm going to need you to get rid of that hope, because it makes no sense. It's all deception. It makes no sense. And now you guys know what to expect from the next part of He-Man. And it just sucks. I have no hope for this. What do you guys think? Am I overreacting? Let me know. Drop a comment in the comment section. Like this episode. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't subscribed already. You guys are awesome. Thank you guys for the 21 subscribers or 20 or 21 subscribers. You guys are great. Let's keep on building this and try and make more unbiased episodes, as unbiased as we can. All right. So I am your host, Dante. Thank you for tuning into the Voice of Reason podcast, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.